Yeah, shall we start now, guys? Yeah, okay. So first three cases we had discussed. Now the last one is hydrolysis of salt. Salt of weak acid and weak base. Weak acid and weak base. For example, we are taking CH3COOH, weak acid, and a base is NH4OH, weak base, okay? So when this reaction takes place, it forms CH3COONH4, that is a base, and water. Ions we have in this salt are, we have CH3COO minus and NH4 plus, right? And both will get hydrolyzed over here, right? Both will get hydrolyzed. So the reaction would be, for hydrolysis, if you see the reaction, CH3COO minus plus NH4 plus dissolve in water forms CH3COOH and NH4OH. This is what the reaction we have. Okay. If the concentration of this salt, I am assuming C and C initially, because it comes from the same salt ions, so we have the same concentration, 0 and 0. Then it becomes C minus CH. This is CH and this is CH. KH, if I write down, it is concentration of CH3COOH divided by concentration of CH3COO minus, okay, into, will have concentration of NH4OH, concentration of NH4 plus, okay, and just to get an expression, I'm multiplying here H plus, multiplying here OH minus, and to cancel out this, we'll multiply H plus and OH minus in the numerator. Can we do this? Yeah, can you do this, guys? What is this then? This is 1 by Ka. This is 1 by Kb for a base. And this is Kw. Okay. So the expression of Kh would be Kw by K into Kb. Remember, like I said in the beginning, that whatever is weak, that will come here in down expression of KH. Here it will come down. Since we have both acid and base weak over here, so both will be here, K into Kb. Yeah, one second, I'll go back. Yeah, done. Okay. Okay, so this is one thing. Now, when you write down the expression of KH in terms of H and C concentration, we'll write down this as CH into CH. Like this. Okay. Concentration will get cancelled. So it is H square by 1 minus H square. Okay. So if you find out H from this, okay, so we'll write down here one H by 1 minus H equals to root over of KH, which is further equals to K into KB. Is it clear? So this is also important. Done. If you find out KH, H in terms of KH here, then what we can write? Root over of KH is equals to H by 1 minus H. So H equals to what we can write? So that hydrolysis, degree of hydrolysis equals to root under KH by 1 plus KH. All these expressions are important. Correct. Okay. Since we need to find out the pH here, so H plus concentration we require. So for H plus concentration, you need to write down the expression for Ka. Ka is equals to CH3COO minus H plus divided by CH3COOH. Okay, CH3CO minus the concentration, you see we have C into 1 minus H. H plus you let it be as it is. CH3COOH is CH we have here. C and C will get cancelled. We'll write Ka is equals to Ka is equals to concentration of H plus 1 minus H by H. Now you see 1 minus H by H. Here we have H by 1 minus H. So if you revert this, you'll get this expression here. So this equals to H plus concentration, you let it be. And 1 minus H by H from this, if you write down, it is Ka into Kb by Kw root over of it. Okay. When you solve this, because we have this expression, you see, I'll write down this in the next page. We have Ka is equals to H plus concentration Ka into Kb by Kw root over of it. This Ka and this Ka will get cancelled. We are left with root over of Ka here. Hence, the H plus concentration equals to K into Kw by Kb root over of it. Right? Important relation, this one also. Now from this, you can easily find out pH. So pH is equals to 7 plus half of pKa minus pKb. Copy this down. Should I go back? Did you write down this? Done. No, derivation is not, you don't have to memorize derivation. Formula you must memorize, the final one. Because since we have 3-4 formulas, no, like this one is important, H plus. KH formula is important. H formula is important. So that's why I did this. Right? Now you see in the previous one, we had either strong acid or a strong base. Based on that, we can say the solution is acidic or basic. But here in this case, both acid and base are weak, correct? So we cannot say directly whether the solution is acidic or basic. It depends upon, obviously you see the pH value, we have this. So whether the solution is acidic or basic, it depends upon the value of pKa and pKb. Correct. So we have three possibilities here based on the value of pKa and pKb. What is that possibility? I'll tell you. There are three possibilities. Case one, if PKA equals to PKB. In this case, pH is equals to what? 7, and hence neutral solution. Case 2, if pKa is greater than pKb, this is true, then we can also write Ka is less than Kb. We know pKa and Ka are inversely proportional. So if Ka is less than Kb, pKa is greater than pKb. If pKa is greater than pKb, then we can say pKa minus pKb is greater than 0. Hence, pH is what? Is greater than 7. Because 7.7 plus something we'll get, no? 7 plus something. pH is greater than 7. So the solution is what? The solution is basic. Another thing, since KB is more, it is basic. Right, we know more value of Ka, more acidic the compound is. More value of Kb, more basic the compound is. Similarly, if Kb is more, then basic. And the last case is the other one, like the third possibility, where Ka is less than Kb, greater than Kb. So the case three we have here. Ka is greater than Kb. When this is true, this is also true. This further means pKa minus pKb less than 0. It means pH is less than 7. Once again, basic. pH is less than 7. Which makes the solution acidic. That is also true because K is more than Kb. Okay, is it clear? Okay, now you try this question. You need to find out the pH, calculate the pH of solution, formed by mixing. First question. 100 ml of 0.1 molar CH3COOH and 100 ml of 0.1 molar NaOH. First one is this. The second one, of 0.1 molar NH4OH with 100 ml of 0.1 molar HCl. Third one, I'll go back, wait. 100 ml of 0.1 molar HCl and 100 ml of 0.1 molar NaOH. The last one is 100 ml of 0.1 molar NH4Cl, 100 ml of 0.1 molar CH3COOH. This is the four question we have. One more data is given over here. Ka value is given. Ka for acid, that is CH3COOH, is 2 into 10 to the power minus 5. And Kb value for the base, which is NH4OH, is 2 into 10 to the power minus 5. Try this. Done. The first one, 8 point something, close, I guess. Yeah. Okay, see, in the first one, see, the number of equivalents or millimoles, whatever you say, if you find out for this, the number of millimoles, it will be 10 millimoles. Here also it is 10 millimoles, right? It means both will get neutralized completely. And when this reaction takes place, it forms a salt, which is CH3COONA and water. Since it gets neutralized completely, complete neutralization, so it is a case of salt hydrolysis, we can apply the formula of pH for the salt of weak acid and strong base. Since the base is strong, so it is basic, pH would be more than 7. So 7 plus half of pKa plus log C. pKa value for this is 5 minus log 2, that is 4.7. 7 plus half of 4.7 plus log C, the concentration of salt would be what? The one that reacts equal amount it will form, that would be 10. 5.7, 5.7 by 2, 2.35. Yeah, it's 10 by 10,000, correct. So we can write 10 to the power minus 2. Okay. So 4.7 minus 2, 2.7. 2.7 by 2 is 1.35. So answer would be 8.35 we get. Okay, similarly, this is a strong acid. This is a weak base. Acha, 4.7 you can get like this. See, K value is what? 2 into 10 to the power minus 5. So pKa is what? 5 minus log 2. Yes. Log A into B is log A plus log B. Got it? It's 4.7. PKB is also 4.7 only here. Okay. So number of millimoles, if you calculate here, because it is millimoles. So if you convert this into moles, 10 by 1000, you will need to write down. Ten millimoles we have, no? Okay. So number of millimoles here, it is again 10. And here also it is 10 again. So we'll write down the pH for acidic solution, which is 7 minus half of pKa. What is the formula of plus or minus C? pKb plus log C. Because base is weak, so we have B over here. So 7 minus half of pKb, again 4.7. And log C is 10 millimoles, so 10 to the power minus 2. So same thing, 7 minus 1.35, that is 5.35 6-5, isn't it? Minus 2, 4.7 minus 2 is 2.7. 2.7 by 2 is 1.35. So 5.65. Is this right? Let's check the calculation once. Clear? Try this one. Third one is 7 because both are strong acid and a strong base. Right? See, it's not like only strong acid and strong base is the condition here. Obviously, answer here is 7. But you need to calculate the number of millimoles here. If it is equal, then only we have complete neutralization. See this. 10 millimoles. Suppose you have 15 millimoles here, then the solution will be basic. And then we can use the formula of mixture of acid and base. Are you getting my point? 5 millimoles extra. So OH minus concentration would be 5 divided by 100 plus 100. And then POH and then pH. Did you get it? In this one, tell me fourth one. Oh, it is, there's a mistake in this. It should be NH4OH, not NH4Cl. Okay, NH4OH right down here. You are getting. It is weak base. See, this one is the weak base and this one is the weak acid. Number of millimoles is same. 10 and 10 we have here. Okay. So we can write down pH is equals to 7 plus half of pKa minus pKb. right? So what is the value of pKa and pKb? pKa and pKb is same. Yeah, pKb value will be given in the question. What are you doing, Anusha? pKa, pKb value is equal, no? Yes. When it is equal, then it should be 7 only, right? Why? These two are equal, so it will be 0. Cancels out, and pH equals to 7. Simple, right? So these are the simplest questions I discussed, but always you see, whenever you have acid-base neutralization, first of all, you count the number of millimoles or milliequivalent. Right? Based on that, you can think about the formula that you should use, the condition. Okay. The next topic we need to understand here is, write down the heading, buffer solution. BUFFER. Definition, write down. A solution which resist the change in pH on addition of a small amount of acid or base is called a buffer solution. Okay. These are the solution which resist the change in pH. Okay. When you add a small amount of acid or base to it. See, first of all, it does not mean that the pH change is zero. It resists the change in pH to a certain extent. Okay. Next line, write down. This does not mean that the pH will not change but it means the pH change would be lesser than the change that would have occurred had it not been, had it not been a buffer solution. Copy this down first. Done. Okay. So the solution is what? These are the solution which resist the change in pH when you add a small amount of acid or base into it. Right. There will be a change in pH, but that change will be too less or lesser than the change if it was not a buffer solution. Right. So if you have two solutions, right, one is buffer, other one is not a buffer solution, add equal amount of acid or base to these two solutions, then you would observe that in the non-buffer solution, the change in pH is more than the buffer solution. That is what the, you know, meaning of buffer solution we have. Okay. It's very important. There are many different solutions which acts as a buffer solution, right? And it tries to maintain the pH. Like in, if I take one example, you have an acid, weak acid, correct? And it's salt with a strong base. So this combination of weak acid and the salt with a strong base gives you a buffered solution. Okay. Buffer solutions are of three types. In this also, we have a pH calculation that we need to do. Okay, so that's what I said, that buffered solution or salt hydrolysis, whatever it is. First of all, you need to identify that what condition we have here. Accordingly, you can use the formula of pH. Okay. Just a second. Okay. So buffer solution, you see, we have three types of buffer solution. The first one is acidic buffer. See, in human body also, if you see, blood has a certain pH value, correct? So if you, eat something like, which increases the pH, H plus concentration or pH of the blood, right, then you will feel uneasy because the pH of the blood has been increased, right? So there is a mechanism by which, you know, the reaction that happens there in the body, it tries to maintain the pH of the blood. If it works well, then you won't feel that uneasy. You will be better in some time. But if it does not go well, then again, you have to take some medicine in order to control the pH of the blood so that everything is fine, right? So basically, we have a lot of examples, like in food preservative also, we require a certain pH. So we mix certain things so that it maintains the pH of the, you know, of the substance over there, so that the food, keeps fresh, or, you know, will be fresh for a certain period of time. So we have a huge application of buffer solution. I'm not talking about a specific kind of buffer solution, whether it is acidic or basic, but application is huge. Like few examples I have given you. Now the question is how this solution works, like how it maintains the pH of its own solution. Again, I'm repeating myself when I say that it does not, you know, change the pH of the solution. It does not mean the change is zero. We'll have a change, but that change is very less, very small, right? Which won't affect much, okay? Or we can say the change is lesser than the change had it not been a buffer solution, okay? That's what the meaning. This theoretical questions also sometimes they ask. What is acidic buffer and how it is prepared? Acidic buffer, again, the same example we have for buffer solution. Acidic buffer is the solution of, copy this down, it is the solution of weak acid and its salt with strong base. Could you give me one example of this? One second, guys. Yeah. Give me one example of this. CH3CONA, yes. No. Yes. We can take CH3COOH. One second, guys. Okay, so what I said here, solution of weak acid and its salts with strong base. So you see here, we have a weak acid, CH3COOH I'm taking, and salt of this weak acid with a strong base, NaOH ladio. So it forms what? CH3COONA plus H2O. So when the reaction takes place between a weak acid and a strong base here, like this, if this is present in excess, then this would be the limiting reagent, right? It gets consumed in the reaction completely. When the reaction gets over, then in the reaction, what all things are left? We have CH3COOH left and CH3COONA present. So when this combination is there, like the combination of a weak acid and its salt with a strong base, that is CH3COONA, this forms an acidic buffer. Got it? That's why you see in salt hydrolysis also, we have the same reaction, But the condition is this two must be equal. If it is not equal, suppose we can write this is either it is excess or NAVA is more than NBVB. If this is the condition we have, NAVA is more than NBVB. Correct? Then it is a condition of buffer solution. Buffer solution forms in this case, and hence we use the formula of buffer here. Yeah, we have the mechanism. We'll discuss how it resists the change in pH. We'll discuss that. But first you understand this. We'll discuss the mechanism. Copy this down. So now you understood the reason why in the salt hydrolysis, we were talking about equal equivalence of this and this. You understood it, right? Clear? So you must keep that in mind. Whenever you get this question, first of all, you calculate the number of equivalents of acid and base, and accordingly, you can use the formula. So this is an example of acidic buffer, CH3COOH with CH3COONA. Okay. Now, how this buffer solution works, you see, there are two reactions here, CH3COONA. It gives CH3COO minus and Na plus. Reaction one. Other one is CH3COOH, which gives CH3COO minus and H plus. So this is the reaction we have. In the solution, we have this ion present. Now what happens? You are adding a small amount of H plus. Acid add kar rahe, right? We are adding acid. It means H plus we are adding. So what happens, since the extra H plus that you are adding to maintain the pH, this H plus, it will consume so that the H plus concentration is maintained, right? So what happens, this extra H plus is taken up by CH3CO minus, and then the second reaction goes in backward direction. Reaction two goes in backward direction. Backward direction to maintain the concentration of H plus. H plus. Okay. If you add a base, OH minus you are adding. OH minus you are adding, then this H plus reaction two goes in forward direction. To maintain the concentration of H plus. So what happens is OH minus that you have added, this OH minus will take this H plus, forms undissociated water molecule, and this reaction goes in forward direction, and the pH will be maintained. H plus concentration will be maintained. The use of this is what? This minus, when H plus it consumes, no, it goes in backward direction. Correct. Further dissociation of this is resisted by this, because these two has one common ion present. So we have here a common ion effect. H plus it consumes, forms a weak electrolyte CH3COOH, which dissociation is further suppressed by the presence of this common ion. And that is how the H plus concentration is maintained. Got it? Understood? Yeah, tell me, guys. Sometimes they ask theoretical questions also on this, like how this works, which reaction goes in which direction. Okay, that also you have to keep in mind. Okay, we have an equation in this, we call it Henderson's equations, right? Okay, there's two more minutes. If I write down the expression for Ka here, it is concentration of CH3 COO minus H plus divided by CH3 COOH. H plus concentration we need to find out. So H plus equals to Ka concentration of acid divided by the concentration of the salt. CH3CO minus is nothing but the salt. If you take log both side, minus of log, minus of log H plus is equals to minus of log Ka plus minus of log CH3COOH, CH3COO minus. Minus of log H plus is pH. Minus of log Ka is Pa, pKa. Plus this minus, I'll take it up and then we'll revert this. So log of salt concentration by acid concentration. This one is salt, CH3CO minus, coming from the salt. And this one is acid. This equation, we call it as Henderson's equation. We'll discuss a bit more about it in the next class, right? Acidic buffer. But this is the equation of acidic buffer. Understood? Yes, guys, understood, clear? Any doubt in this? Okay, so next class we'll continue with this acidic buffer, then we'll see basic buffer and salt buffer. Okay, I will share one PDF today. You solve that. Okay, assignment. Yeah, bye. Take care. Thank you.